to do dishes with two sinks. My method. Part 1. Do not panic about how messy it may look, because it will get clean. First off, I put the dirty dishes on this side with the garbage disposal. Super excited to have it. And then I rinse it off and put it over here, because I don't want my soapy water to be really gross with a lot of pieces of food. When I do dishes, I have one brush. It's the dirty brush. And I use it for cleaning off dirty dishes. Make sure that other people know that and they're not going to use it for cleaning vegetables or washing dishes. This is a designated dirty brush. When I have a dish that's really oily, really dirty, I'm going to use hot water and put soap on the brush and just give that a pre-wash. Once again, I just don't want my soapy main water to be really gross and nasty, because I'm going to use that water also at the end to clean off the countertops. And here is my little companion. Hi! Okay, part 1 is done. Everything has been scrubbed. So this is basically utensils, plates, cups, and then I've got the bowls and Tupperware waiting and the larger dishes. So these have been pre-cleaned, just a quick scrub down. And then I just rinsed out my sink and I fill that up with hot soapy water. Another tidbit is don't forget to empty the rack from yesterday's or whenever you did it before, because it'll be filled up with water. So I always do that too. Empty it out and then I'm ready to start a new one. Let's do this. When we moved in, these were already here. These are stoppers for the sink. Some stoppers are metal. You can buy them at Walmart or any other kind of stores. This works really well, although at times it can be really hard to pull it out later. But this works good. So stop out the sink, hot water, some soap, and let it scrub together. Then I start with my plates and cutting board. I get the cutting board. And that plate. And then we got two utensils. Little plastic cups for children, stick it inside like that so it takes up less room in the sink. And I'm going to do this one later because these are really sharp. Okay, so for this side, I'm going to use the sprayer, spray off the sides, empty the. These are really great, and you can get these at Walmart or even the dollar store probably, and they help to capture anything that goes down the drain. They'll capture anything that goes down the drain, so I really recommend buying these. They do a lot better job than those metal plugs, sink plugs, that have these big holes. They cannot capture a lot of stuff. This really captures a lot more stuff. So while this is filling up, normally I'm going over here and I'm just going to clean off the sides. Do a quick rinse like this, and then I'm going to go empty this in the garbage, tap it out if it was full. Now I'm going to put down some soap and just use my hand to scrub the sides of the sink. So something that's helpful is that when I clean these big cups, because I have them every day because we make fruit shakes in the morning. So when this is cleaned, it's over here, and then I put all my utensils, spoons, knives, forks, everything will be in here, so it's not actually touching the sink. So I'm not worried about using bleach to sanitize the sink, because none of that important stuff is going to touch the sink, and all the cups will be standing up. So I just do a quick wash with my hand. And just right now, I'm just going to do a quick rinse. And now this side is ready to go. So I just add soap to my sponge. And whenever it needs more soap, I put more soap. Remember the science behind soap. The soap is designed to capture the dirt and germs in the bubbles. And then the water washes the bubbles and soap away. So if you don't have soap and bubbles, it's not capturing and taking away the stuff. And it's there to help to scrub it away. Okay, let's go and get it done. We got part one done. Got the plates and the cups washed. And now I'm gonna add another batch in here. There's more room to add for soaking. So my setup is a little backwards. I'm gonna have to go over here, rinse it, bring it over here to the drainer. Normally, you would have the draining rack here, so it just goes from the rinse into the draining. But I don't want to lose the space for working. I'd rather lose this space. And I'm just going to keep it out during the day. Some people put it away when they're done doing dishes, but I'm constantly cooking something and cleaning something. So it's not really practical for me. So mine is a little backwards, but that's fine. It works. You could also just put down a towel. Something I do to save space in my drying rack is try to combine things as much as I can. So I've got all these cups here, and I'm just gonna put this one on top. Ba-bam! It's like a little puzzle. This plate always falls forward, so I just put it there. Alright, we're progressing. So I got all my utensils and serving things are all in the cups. And I also try to use a bowl or a container to keep the little pieces, like measuring cups and parts of the blender. They'll be kept there. Okay, so let's rinse them up. We're getting there. I also separated out the Tupperware containers. So now they're soaking. And I think I'm going to add this bowl. Last time I cooked chiles rellenos, stuffed chiles, Mexican recipe. And it always is the most time consuming and the dirtiest dishes recipe, so it was extra to do. Okay, so what I like to do is I rinse all these out and stick it in here, and then I get the container and rinse that out, and now it's ready, and I just pile everything back in. Okay, now it's ready for the silverware. Okay, we made it. Everybody is washed. And these bigger items or anything that's harder, I just stack them up on top of the burners because the burners are clean. The rest of it's dirty. And then I get my dishcloth. It's good to have ones that have a little texture to them to help you scrub. And I use my soapy water, which is why I didn't want my dishes to be covered in gross food. I want to be able to use all this water and soap. And so I just stick it in the water, squeeze out extras, and then I usually fold it in four or whatever. And scrub, scrub, scrub. So maybe I'll have my boys look at these. I've got four boys now. I'm gonna have them watch these videos and be like, now you know how to clean the kitchen, clean it. Yeah, so I've already cleaned this out. Yesterday I used my kitchen scissors to cut off the poblanos. So I just cleaned those with the towel. This is the bottle from yesterday. It's waiting to be washed. I'm just waiting for the one from today. And then I'm going to move these dishes over there and clean the stovetop. Okay, so the kitchen part is done. I found some dishes in another room, so that's tip number one. Locate all dishes from all the rooms in the house. I need to clean the table and their chairs. Got really messy yesterday. So maybe I'll do it tonight or maybe tomorrow. Alright, so the part that's important is if you want to reuse this towel the next day, if it wasn't too dirty, just let it dry completely, just like the sponge. When things are able to dry out completely, then they won't become stinky or gross. And that's it. So I hope this helps if you're not very confident, if you're new to washing dishes. by hand. Here's just an idea for what to do with two sinks. It's really helpful. I'm really grateful to be in a home that has this set up, especially the garbage disposal. Super grateful for that. And I'm just gonna pull the plug, hopefully. Okay, it's easy. Rinse this off, and don't forget to rinse out your sink. And that's the end of it. Thanks for joining me in the daily adventure. Have a great day. Thanks for hanging out.